Lane speed limit is 35 miles per hour. Looks like you're clear on the pit exit.
Clear right.
Exit looks clear.
Right side. Still there. Still there. Clear right. On your right, clear right. On your right, hold your line. Hold your line, clear right.
Watch your speed. Engage limiter, box in 310 meters. Meters. 50 meters. 15 minutes left.
Okay, now I understand what's going on. It had gone back to having the issue that I had earlier on today while I was messing with it. Well, not messing with it, but you know, setting everything up.
Hold your line, clear right.
The leader has just done a 126.3.
I actually saw a funny Reddit video.
Clear right.
Well. Funny for the viewer, not for the guy involved. Somebody was leading a race, and a back marker was coming out of the pits, and he just goes flying across the grass and smashes into the leader and takes him out.
Car left, still there. Hold your line, clear left, on your left. Hold your line, still there, clear left.
Old Lando there. So yeah, the force feedback, this IRFFB, it's supposed to help with oversteer and understeer, but maybe I need to switch it off to notice the difference. But what I've been talking about with the AI races is getting some proper driver names. I know the names there, I think they're like famous. Famous streamers and people involved with iRacing, like Ozzy Gregg, I think, and Jimmy Broadbent, guys like that.
New fastest lap for Verstappen, 23.7.
So yeah, we've got all the big names, and we've got the liveries, and
hold your line, clear right.
So yeah, we've got drivers from past and present. I've put everyone from Lewis Hamilton, Max Verstappen, Leclerc, Sainz, all the big names, and Albon, and then we've got Niki Lauda, oh, come on! Yeah, I've after trying to
sector one is 2.9 seconds off the pace.
Move up to the USF 2000 and the Formula 3. I think I need to just chill out and just stick to this one really.
The track temperature's rising. It's now 42 Celsius.
And then just do the GT4.
Sector 2 is 0.4 off the pace.
Just do the GT4 stuff and
Turn 5. Looks like it's Ricardo.
Ricardo. Even the AI Ricardo's having a bad time of it.
God. Sector 1 is 1.2. Off the pace.
I can't say that this force feedback is doing much for me, to be honest. But I have downloaded it in the past. But again, that Gamer Muscle was talking about it, saying it's a must-have.
Your sector 2 time is quick.
So, we'll stick with it. But yeah, I had an AI F3 race, and actually one thing I've realised with the AI races is you can actually restart them. So if you start and you have like a massive crash in the first corner, if you mess up.
P23, you're now 3.0, off the leader's pace. Sector 3 is 1.9, off the pace.
You can just start the race again, is really good, because really what I need to use the AI races for is racecraft, learning how to race, because it puts you in scenarios where you're offline. I actually uploaded a video on Twitter of a nice little battle I had today while I was testing a few things out at Alton Park. And that was an AI. That was an AI battle.
Sector 2 time is good.
The only thing is with the AI, I've got to try and get it. Oh, come on! Got to try and
yellow flag.
I've got to try and get the skill level right. But we should be able to do a 125, 124.
Sector 1 is 0.8, off the pace. The leader has just done a 124.9. Sector 2 time is okay.
Left side, clear left.
What? Who the hell was dive bombing there?
P17, that puts you 1.3 seconds off the pace. Okay, Rick, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. Sector 3 is 0.9, off the pace.
A minute behind us.
Sector 1 is 1.2 seconds off the pace. The leader's just done a 24.0.
Yeah, and Senna's in there as well.
Sector 2 time is good.
Far left, clear left.
Where the hell?
You're currently 2.1 seconds off the pace. Sector 3 is 1.3 seconds off the pace.
So sector 3 were.
Sector 1 is 1.1, off the pace.
So we're only 17th is where we were in the GT card against the AI. So. Oh, and I messed up today as well, I thought.
Off the pace in Sector 2.
I thought the Formula One was back today. Turns out it's another week, isn't it?
Right side, hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Clear right.
That's Bottas.
Sector 3 is 2.5 off the pace. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
But F1 style.
On your left. Hold your line. Still there. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Hold your line. Left side. Hold your line. Clear left.
Sector 1 is 0.9 off the pace.
Yeah, this will teach me to be able to stay
right
close.
Right side. Clear right.
Like that and not without hitting somebody.
Sector 2 is 1.2 off the pace.
Without hitting somebody real, basically. So, and it's, like I say, one good thing I've realised is in a regular race, you go off
car
in
left.
The.
Hold your line, still there. Hold your line, still there.
You go
there.
Off in the first
hold your
corner,
line. Clear left.
And that's it, it's all over, you're at the back, and whereas. In the day I race,
sector 3 is 1.5 off the pace.
You know, I really need to learn my racecraft, and if these cars are faster than you think, you know, just because you have one, you know, really, I'm playing the game.
Okay, Rick, you've got half your fuel left.
Keeping it clean and just staying on the track and letting everyone.
Sector 1 is 1.3 off the pace.
Crash out. But where I'm not good is where I've got
check
to follow right behind
place.
Somebody.
You've got 10 minutes left, 10 minutes to go.
Car right, still there, clear right.
Look out for the pit speed limit. Pit lane speed limit is 35 miles per hour. Engage the limiter. Box in 310 meters.
So best lap 25 dead.
100 metres. 50 metres.
So Michael Schumacher, Max Verstappen, Lewis 124-0 right in centre. Sergio Perez, it's brilliant. And they're all in the liveries and everything, so.
That's the end of the session, P17.
Just gives it a little more.
Checkered flags out, 17th place.
Just makes it a little more fun. So, qualifying now. But yeah, I'm not really seeing the benefit of this IR04.
Pit exit is clear. Okay, Rick, we've got 2 laps to get the job done.
But I'm going to stick with it because, obviously, who am I? You know, I'm just some idiot in shorts. Idiots that have been doing this longer than me that say it's really good. So. Yeah, but things like the racing line, you know, Jesus Christ. It's things like that because I wasn't doing that yesterday. We were flying yesterday.
The track temperature is increasing. It's now 43 Celsius.
And we were stuck to the track like glue. So. To me, understeer, you can hear it in the tyres. You don't need to. And I'm not, like I said, I'm not, I've got it on 100% understeer. The seat of the pants thing, I still don't really understand what the hell that is. I thought that's supposed to be oversteer, but to be honest, I'm not really, maybe I'm in the wrong car for oversteer, I don't know. Oversteer isn't used in my opponents, it's understeer. But it's on 100% understeer. So, I might need to turn it off to see if there's any further difference. But I think what I'm realising is that I'm moving too quickly. Look. You know what? Can't go back to the pit.
The lead is just 123.7.
Maybe it's the fact that I've got it turned up to 100% because I've just turned it off and straight away it feels a million times better.
Sector 2 is 0.4 off the pace.
So. Feels a million times better and then it flies off, so. Right. I'd say it feels a million times better. It's just... just smoother. I think maybe I need to tweak the setting. So many different versions of this thing as well, because people talk about it saying it sits between... Oh, please! It's just going off every time at that corner. And all the YouTube videos are on it. They talk about the fact it sits between you and an iRacing, but when you enable it, it turns off the force feedback in iRacing. You can't adjust it. So you're left wondering, does it turn it off? Or is it completely overriding the force feedback? In which case, that's where I don't think...
62 is 1.7 off the pace.
It is as good. Because Gamer Muscle was talking about the interpolation. In the modern software. Oh, come on. What is suddenly going on? Have we got damage? Okay.
Watch your speed limit in the pits.
Well, I need to check. If we've got damage, then...
Activate limiter. Box in. 310
meters. We've got damage. Actually, we can go back. Yeah, we can go back and redo it.
You're all clear. Stay behind the line. We've got 2 laps. Let's get this done.
Let's see if it was damaged, because I couldn't bring up the... I'm sure it is. I don't know what... time ever. That's just screwing my head in a bit.
It looks like Ricardo.
I can't hear the engine.
The track temp's increasing. It's now 42 Celsius.
The engines in these things aren't that loud, really. something not right, because I never had any problem in that corner at all.
Sector 2 is 2/10 off the pace. P16, that puts you 3.0 off the leader's pace. Sector 3 is 1.5 off the pace. Sector 1 is 1.2 seconds off the pace. You're 2/10 off the pace in Sector 2.
Oh, Jesus. Oh. I honestly don't know what, You know what, force feedback intensity, I've just tweaked that because I've always had it 100%, but I've always had the...
Exit's clear, don't cross the white line.
The intensity is different to the strength. The strength is, you know, 100%. I want the full, like, 8 newton meters, and that's what we've got. But the intensity is apparently how harsh and sharp, and that's what... That's how things have been, I think. Too harsh. still doesn't feel right, but it's definitely different. Oh, have I not gone?
That's the end of the session, the 20th place.
But yeah, that still didn't.
All clear on pit exit. All right, Rick, we've got 2 laps to set a decent time. Pit exit's clear.
Yeah, IR FFB is definitely not running now, so that, this is the thing when you tweak bloody things and something still, iRacing still thought IR FFB was running even though I turned it off. You don't know if the changes you, things were definitely changing now. But yeah, I need to dial in this force feedback, it is an important thing. To be honest, in many ways, things like this where there's so many different ways to do something, there's so many different settings and options, it's overwhelming really. It's just like with the pedals, it takes you months to get anywhere. You've got to really be patient in to get your sim set up just right. Because also you've got different cars, and I must admit I'm the type of guy that would like to just set things up and just leave it, whether it's a GT car or an F4 car or whatever. So let's just stay in practice for a minute, and actually we need to tweak So I wanted to tweak the strength here. Right, this looks like it can move now. Yeah, okay. So I want to get that to 12. Oh, Jesus Christ. Honest to God. Well, that's 12.1. See, I wish they didn't just have sliders. I wish they had the up and down arrows.
Your exit's
as well.
Clear. Don't cross the white line.
Right, now I can feel the bumps. And it's fairly strong. I don't know what that IRO4 does to me. IRFFB. I was watching that Skip Barber video that Sassy mentioned. I've watched the first part of it anyway.
On your right, clear right.
Sergio. And yeah, it looks like it covers out, you know, trail braking and talks about weight transfer and things. I've got to try and get my head around it because I understand weight transfer, what they're saying, you know, you break in, the weight moves to the front, accelerate moves to the back, and how you... It's applying that. You know, it yeah, I don't understand how, like going through that corner there, how is somebody able to transfer weight differently than what I can? I don't. It's got to be about apex speed, it has. Yeah, it just seems to have lost confidence in, because I was absolutely flying around here in the race yesterday.
P3. All clear on pit exit, you can push now. New fastest lap for Perez, 124.5.
I don't even know if you need to drop a gear going into that, going up this hill. But I always lose time here because you're absolutely petrified of something going wrong.
The guy ahead's lap time is 1:31.4. P17. Sector 1 is 0.6 off the pace. Fastest lap for Verstappen, 1:24.0. Your sector 2 time is quick. The leader has just done a 1:26.4. The guy ahead has just done a 1:31.3. P14, good lap. That's your quickest today. You're now 1.7 seconds off the pace. Sector 3 is 1.5 seconds off the pace. The guy behind has just done a 1:25.7. That's a new fastest lap for Gasly, 1:24.0. There's an incident in turn 5. We think it might be Ricciardo. Sector 1 is 0.4 off the pace.
Ricciardo,
caution.
Ricciardo not having any luck in real life or simulated life.
Sector 2 time is okay. The leader has just done a 1:25.5.
DRS train here for her.
P11, that's your quickest lap in this session. That puts you 0.9 off the leader's pace. Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace. Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace.
On your right. Still there, clear right.
Now it's good practice for moments like that. When the moment comes in real life.
Sector 2 is 0.8 off the pace.
Left side, hold your line. Hold your line, on your left. Oh. Hold your line, clear left, left side.
Sorry. There's an incident in turn 11. We think it might be Vettel.
Clear all round.
Clear. Sorry, that was me. That's exactly what I was just saying.
We'll need to pit for repairs. We've had the black and orange flag.
Yeah, that was totally on me there. This is exactly why I'm gonna stick with AI racing for a while, because I need to improve my own abilities, you know, in all different situations like this. You know, I think that bit was okay, but then obviously hitting Gasly, and then he hit. You know, but was that bit okay? Should I have gone the other way? Thing is, when you've got momentum, it's difficult. But I probably should have waited and gone down the inside.
Take care, there's a car approaching.
I want to go back and just tweak another setting.
Fastest lap for Verstappen, 123.6.
Let's try it on 40% intensity. Because I'm just feeling like there's a bit of mechanical...
There's a car behind, take care, rejoin him.
There's like a mechanical rattle in there. It doesn't feel... Doesn't feel natural, you know. Right, there we go. That's feeling a bit better.
Five minutes left. You're a second off in sector one. Okay. 14th. You're now 1.6 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.9 off the pace. Temps increasing, it's now 43 Celsius. Sector 1 is 0.7 off the pace. Sector 2 time is quick. You're currently 1.6 off the pace. Sector 3 is 1.2 seconds off the pace.
At least we've stopped spinning in that corner. I don't know what the hell I was doing.
Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go. Sector 1 is 0.9 off the pace.
That's how fast we need to be taking.
Incident in turn 11. It looks like it's Schumacher. We need to find a 10th in sector 2. Watch your speed. Engage limiter. Box in 310 meters. Meters, 50 meters, 1. Okay, Rick, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. Checker flags out, 16th place.
So let's turn into a bit of a test session, I'm afraid. Sorry about this. Been going for an hour now. I've got to get it right though. There's no point carrying on until we get everything set up. I'm realizing that I've not actually fully...
Track's clear. Push, push, push.
Fully explored the force feedback. and what it should feel like. To be honest, I'd love, you know, it'd be great to be able to actually get in a real race car. Perez is quick, I think. If we can keep up with Perez.
Your quickest overall. Done a 124.9. 15 minutes left, that's 15 minutes.
So I think we're definitely going in the right direction with the force feedback, because I didn't realise how harsh I had it really. And it doesn't, it's not supposed to be harsh, I don't think. I mean, it's supposed to be smooth. Smooth, but deep, you know, find that detail within smooth kind of thing. and this is feeling much better.
The guy ahead has just posted a 127.2. Sector 2 time is good. New fastest lap for Alonso, 124.3. That's a new fastest lap for Verstappen, 124.1.
Magnussen is holding up Perez.
7th position, you're currently 1.1 seconds off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.4 off the pace.
And we need to get wider on entry. That's it.
Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace. The guy behind has just done a 125.2. You were 10th off the pace in Sector 2.
Yeah, I've realised that I think I've had everything set wrong. The brakes, the accelerator, the wheel.
E9, you're now 4.6 off the pace. You're a second down in Sector 3. Sector 1 is 0.4 off the pace.
But also, I think the understeer is totally smoothed out.
Fastest lap for Sainz, 124.0. Sector 2 is 0.4 off the pace. The leader has just done a 3.11.5. The guy behind has just done a 124.9.
Car left. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Clear left. On your left. Still there. On your left. Clear left.
B12,
that puts you 1.7 off the leader's pace. Sector 3 is 0.9 off the pace.
Sorry, I meant to.
Sector 1 is quick.
I went to do a tear off and I went down a gear instead.
Ricardo 10 minutes remaining, 10 minutes. You're a 10th off the pace in Sector 2.
What car is Ricardo in? He's in black.
New fastest lap for Verstappen, 123.8.
Verstappen crushing it. Ricardo should be in the McLaren livery. I don't know what's happened to the liveries.
P12. P15. You're currently 2.7 off the leader's pace. Sector 3 is 1.1 seconds off the pace. The leader's just done a 219.0.
Car right. Still there. Still there. Clear right. Right side. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Still there.
Go on, Perry.
Hold your line. Clear right.
That's what I love about the AI.
Off the pace.
Car left. Still there. Still there. Hold your line. Hold your line. Hold your line. Still there. Hold your line. Clear left.
Sector 3 is 1.4. Off the pace.
Hamilton behind us.
Sector 1 is 1.1, off the pace. There's an incident in turn 5. It looks like Ricardo.
Clear left.
Ricardo, okay. Oh, Russell and Hamilton, come on, let's try. You got an off track there, and I must admit, I've only been out there when
Sector 2
crashed.
Is 2.4 seconds off the pace. Place. Sector 3 is
left side, clear left.
New fastest lap for Schumacher, 123.7. Sector 1 is 0.8, off the pace. Sector 2 time is good. That's half fuel. You've used half your fuel.
I'm happy with the force feedback as it is. I think we'll...
What's your speed limit in the pits? Box in 310 metres.
Still a little bit lumpy, but I'm thinking, what's the suspension
okay,
in
Rick,
these
five
things?
Minutes
I
to
mean,
go, 5 minutes left. 100 metres.
Hardly, I'd have...
50 metres.
Let me just have a think of them.
Fastest lap for Schumacher, 123.5. track temperature's rising. It's now 43 Celsius. There's traffic behind. Watch your mirrors.
On your right. Still there. Still there. Hold your line. Clear right. Right side. Clear right. Car right. Clear right.
Incident in turn 11. You think it might be Schumacher? P17. Two minutes to go. Sector 1 is 0.6 off the pace. Sector 2 time is okay. P16, good lap, that's your best in the session. That puts you 1.2 seconds off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.8 off the pace. Checkered flag, P16. Okay, Rick, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. We'll be right back. That's the end of the session. 16th place. Checkered flags out. P16. Track temperature is increasing. It's now 43 Celsius. The leader has just done a 123.5. We'll be right back.